Hello, welcome to this week's episode of The Shtick. Every week we bring you something quite different, and this week it's going to be, again, a bit of variety for your viewing pleasure and for your interest as well, because we have somebody of very great interest in the studio this week. His name is Manny Waks.
Hi, Henry.
Great to see you.
Great to see you too. Welcome back to Melbourne.
Thank you. Always great to be back.
Yeah, you're living in Israel now.
I am. I've been there for the last couple of years, but to me, Melbourne has been home and will be home once again, I hope.
Did you make Aliyah proper?
We did make Aliyah, yes.
Wow, that's a big step.
A big step, a great experience for the children as well. So, you know, we're there for a number of reasons. I'll continue to live there, but I certainly have my sights set back on Australia at some stage.
I don't blame you for living in Israel, because if I had a choice, I'd be there as well.
Okay. We can maybe make an exchange at some point.
Yeah, you can come and live here. I'll live over there for a while, because it's a great country. But Australia's been the place where you have been educated and where you were established as a community leader.
Yes, I held various leadership positions in the mid-2000s in the Jewish community, Anti-Defamation Commission, Canberra Jewish Community, Executive Council of Australian Jewry. So I've very much been active in the Jewish community in Australia.
And something happened where you decided you had to speak your mind about something that happened to you as an 11, 12-year-old?
Yes, so when I was in 2011 as the Vice President of the Jewish community, I felt... for a number of reasons, I decided on that time. But it was an issue that needed to be addressed and wasn't being addressed by anyone, the issue of child sexual abuse in the Jewish community. And I spoke out about my personal experience at the Yeshiva Center, about the abuse, about the cover-ups. And then soon after that, the follow-up, the intimidation, the ongoing abuse continued. And certainly that did raise the profile around the issue.
Mm. You were on the Shtick in 2013, 14 and 17, and each time I've updated our viewers and had the pleasure of having your company on the show, and I wanted to know just a little bit more about the background of how it affected your life.
Well, I mean, firstly, the fact that we started this program is the fact that I'm living in Israel. I mean, there is no question that that is the main reason that we are living in Israel at the moment, is because of the events that followed my public disclosure of the abuse in 2011, because the pushback from the community, especially the leadership and especially within the rabbinate, and even more so within the Yeshiva Center community, Chabad community, both in Australia and globally, all forced us essentially to leave Australia for our own benefit, mainly to try to move forward. But obviously we have seen significant progress from where things were in 2011 and even those few years after that. We had the Royal Commission into Institutional Responses to Child Sexual Abuse, where the findings were unequivocal about what happened. And obviously I felt fully vindicated, and so did everyone else who was on the right side of justice and of history. So... There have been some wonderful developments, positive developments since that time in these 7-odd years. We've seen a Jewish community in Australia and beyond change their attitude around this issue. Parents, students, staff, members, volunteers, everyone is talking about this issue in a much more open way. And that can only assist in the ongoing fight to address child sexual abuse, because awareness and speaking openly about these issues is what actually is going to act as a deterrence for perpetrators to feel that they continue to harm children with impunity, and at the same time allow those who have been abused and empower them to come forward and seek the help that they need.
Because you've also been in the media as far as writing a book. You wrote a book in...
about a year and a half ago, yes. With Michael Visonte, my co-author. The book was called Who Gave You Permission? And yes, in fact, I was just in the US, and I'll be heading out there for a mini book tour as well soon. But I did feel like it was the right time to share my story, in my own words, as opposed to relying constantly on various media articles and programs to convey their story from their perspective. It was a very big challenge to do that from a whole lot of perspectives, but I certainly tried to be as honest and as forthright as I can be about my life.
And there are also two documentaries made about you by Danny Ben-Moshe and Dan Goldberg?
Correct. The first one, Code of Silence, which won a Walkley Award for them, which I was very happy for them because they dedicated a lot of time and effort to that. And then afterwards, Breaking the Silence, which took place more after the Royal Commission to follow up the development. So I'm grateful in many ways for that opportunity, for all this exposure, because ultimately what it does is lift the profile of the issue of child sexual abuse and how we may be able to combat it, and about holding individuals and institutions to account and preventative measures and the like. So really the media interest and community support has really ensured that this issue has become elevated, not quite to where it needs to be, but certainly it has raised the profile and therefore made our community a lot safer.
In a very big way, it has really done that. And I think that your group, TheShtick, which you started, you formed that in what year?
2012. I formed Tzedek, which means justice in Hebrew. It really comes from the concept of Tzedek, Tzedek Tirdof, justice you shall pursue. And I felt that that was the right approach that was needed. Initially, the focus was about victim support and advocacy. In the years since I've left, it's still going. They've got a board, a CEO. They're focusing much more on the preventative aspects of it. My personal view is that there's still a lot more work to be done in the advocacy space. The fact that we are seeing still a lot of, I was talking about before, the positive developments, but there are some incredibly hurtful things still going on within the Jewish community, also within the yeshiva community specifically.
Manny, we're going to go out of this segment right now because we've got to talk about other things, the present moment, actually.
Sure.
I want to go to the next segment. So we'll be back in the next segment with more of Manny Waks and just the most interesting topic.